one last plea. What can we do? We cannot keep him with us now. A scandal to his own, a folly unto us. Sentence is passed. 'Tis writ in Hebrew, Latin, Greek. The crowd still shouts. The judge still washes clean his hands.
Thank you.
must be made, each special roughness met. The foot will often fall, though heart may persevere. By thy most holy knees, whose weakness caused the fall, by thy heart strengthened at the fearful way. O Lord, by spare that trapped thee, and by earth that stung, save me from that first sin that takes one unaware.
Thank you.
use us, even unto force, to share thy cause. So Simon there was drawn to bear his share of it. With strength he seized the wood and followed thee, lest portion of thy cause should drag or suffer loss. The sixth station, Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. Disciples all have fled. Peter denied him thrice. Yet, hurling herself against insults and the threat of death, Veronica receives his face between her hands. Teach us, O brave woman, to conquer human fear. To whom Christ is not an image, but the truth, will come the questioning glance of other men. Yet he dwells on higher plane. He thinks apart. Some strange love holds him distant. He is not the same. An adult man, he says his deeds, he tells his sins, Friday he fasts, and with the women he goes to mass. Of course he rises after, Gatherer of grapes, lifted to ecstasy by God's own each carrying her own child. Let us go on and listen to, for Jesus speaks. The lifted hand shows him, though man is more than man. This scene reveals the God who suffered for our sake. And since he is our God, his act is for all time. This day, in very truth, God suffers for our sins. From what then, and at what a price, has he saved us? Our tongue is beggared when we say, for this the Son was forced to tear himself from his own Father's side. If this the price at which we've saved, what then is hell? If our sick souls ask this, what of the Christless dead?
Save us, O Lord, from this last
left to thee, for they have taken all. They plucked the robe from thee, as yet before they snatched from monk his cow, from virgin nun her veil. Nothing is left wherewith he might be clothed himself, in naked helplessness, as naked as a worm, without defense he stands, exposed to sight of men. What, this your Christ, this mocked derided one, this wretched man begrimmed, a mass of wounds and sores, a subject he for alienists and for the courts? Jesus murmurs, fierce fools, besiege me, Lord, deliver me from savage dogs. He is not Christ, nor son of man. He is not God. His gospel is a lie. His father's not in heaven. A fool, a fake. Why speaks he not? What holds his tongue? The high priest serves, strikes. The kiss of Judas. Then the mob. They left thee stripped, but there remains thy robe of blood. They left thee not, but still that aching wound is thine. Though God be hid away, here stands the man of grief. Though God be hid, I see my brother here who weeps. By thy humiliation, Lord, by thy deep shame, pity the vanquished ones who to the stronger yield. And by thy ghastly clothing at the final hour, great pity have on all my bitter anguish pierced. The little child who thrice must bear the surgeon's knife, the wounded man whose wounds must be with pain redressed, the husband shamed who, the son who mourns a mother's death, have pity on that love which our hearts must uproot.
Thank you.
takes our human form. The cross is placed, his body dislocated, cracked. As by a heavy wine press, he is crushed and torn. With truth, the prophet David said in ancient days, my hands and feet are pierced, revealed my every bone. O Savior, thou art bound, escape was not for thee. Upon the cross these nails held thee by hands and feet. I seek no further now, no heretic and fool. This God, by these four nails constrained, sufficeth me. He drains the cup, he drinks the slow advancing death. Jesus is taken down from the cross. The passion ends. Mercy, its fruit, forever reigns. Down from the cross, he lies within his mother's arms. Calvary perfected her will of Nazareth. The Christ who, lifted up, bore only the shame, his mother takes one more alone unto herself. And in those arms the church guards well her well-beloved. What God sent forth, what Mary gave, what man has done, all is now within her heart forevermore. She holds him, sees and weeps, and in her tears adores. She, cerement and ointment is, and tomb and myrrh.